guys, it's Kelly. Welcome back to my channel. And you know what time it is. It's time for January Favorites, the video where I get to share all the skincare products that I've been using that have made a big impression on me this month. And what a month it's been, right? It's been a doozy. I don't think that, you know, that this month was really the vision that we had for the new year for 2021, but it is what it is, right? And we just keep rolling with it. We just keep persevering and we just keep going. And I think that that is, I think we've all just become stronger people, definitely. But, well, that stuff aside, right? There's definitely been some big developments in the skincare community as well. And the big sort of like development this month is the revelations around the Keep Cool and Soothe Bamboo Sun Essence. One of my favorite, or I guess ex-favorite sunscreens, yet another sunscreen that has failed to meet the SPF claims that is on its label. That's right, the Keep Cool sunscreen's been pulled from the market. If you guys have no idea what I'm talking about, by the way, I did make a video breaking down this whole thing, so I will link it for you guys right up here. You can check that out and see what the heck I'm talking about. But, you know, needless to say, a lot of us are extremely disappointed. It's been a tough month. It's been a tough month. But all that being said, you know what? There was still skincare. We still enjoyed our routines. And there were still products that made me particularly happy this month. And that's what I'm here to share. So if you guys are so ready to find out what my favorite products from January were, give the video a big thumbs up and let's get started. All right, first up is the 100% Tamanu oil from Tuso Wong. I am so excited to finally have Tamanu oil in my life. Now, I have slowly but surely been getting onto the Tamanu oil train. Sounds weird. I've slowly been starting to become a fan of it. You know, it is that kind of like the skincare ingredient du jour a little bit. It has been gaining a lot of popularity really because of Lia Yu. You know, she really put this ingredient on the map, and it is an ingredient that has helped her a lot with her acne, her hyperpigmentation, and really she said it's like one of the only products that really helps her with her scars. You know, Tamanu oil is a really interesting oil because it's got a lot of healing properties, a lot of wound healing properties. It's a fantastic oil for calming inflammation on the skin and really helping to repair the skin, along with its great sort of fatty acid profile and its abilities to moisturize the skin. It can also help improve acne, and it can help improve redness, scars, hyperpigmentation. Tamanu oil will definitely give your complexion a boost, so to speak. So it's an oil that definitely is a little bit more supercharged with some extra benefits you just don't get from every facial oil. All right, let's talk performance. And the first thing I have to tell you is this is an oil that has a scent. There is no fragrance or anything like that in here. There is a natural scent from Tamanu oil. It's famous for smelling funky. And if you've tried Crave Great Barrier Relief or the Sioris You Look So Young Night Cream, you're gonna be familiar with the smell, and it's obviously really concentrated when you're just using the oil pure by itself. Everybody's sense of smell is very different. I have a very unique approach to scent and how I describe it, but I'm gonna give it a shot here. To me, it really has a very earthy kind of scent profile to it. And when I say earthy, I don't mean trees and pine needles and stuff. I mean like actual dirt, like wet dirt kind of smell. It's got that type of earthiness to it, along with, this is so strange, I know, but just this is what comes up in my mind every time I smell this. It also has this sort of like reminder to me of like a really like freshly baked, really yeasty, very salty smelling pretzel. Funky for sure. Bothersome? To me, no. I am actually starting to like the smell of this. I think just because I associate it with what it does to my face, and so I'm kind of enjoying it now. And what does it do to my face? It's got such a wonderful healing quality to it. I have been going through a period of irritation. I have overly dry skin, which thankfully I have come back from the edge of. My skin is doing so much better than it was when I was making my my winter ultimate moisturizing routine, right? I've definitely recovered, which is great. But you know, for the majority of the month, I was dealing with a lot of irritation around my mouth, a lot of real severe dryness around my nose and everything. And I was using a variety of different oils to help me out with that. But I can tell you, this is an oil that did bring relief to my skin. This really does calm inflammation. It does really calm irritation. I feel like this helps with redness as well. I wasn't able to try it out on any like active pimples, not yet, but I can tell you it does help with hyperpigmentation because I did have a bunch of pimples that went away but left dark marks. This is helping. You know, Tamanu oil has proven itself time and time again to me that it helps to brighten up my skin. And when you're just using the concentrated goodness in this bottle, it really does help so much. Let's talk about the texture. I really like the texture of this. It's actually kind of like medium to light type of oil. It's kind of somewhere nicely in the middle. It's got a really beautiful spreadability and it's got a really fast absorbency into the skin. This is one of the most pleasing textures of oils that I have. Now, you may notice in the texture that it is a bit cloudy. And in fact, I do have a little bit of sediment at the bottom of my bottle. And I thought like maybe there was something wrong with this oil, like it had gone off. And I do want to actually assure you that that is not the case. Pure Tamanu oil does have a tendency to go a little bit cloudy and have a little bit of sediment in it when it drops below a certain temperature, which I think is about 21 degrees Celsius, which is like 69 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's this was shipped to me in November. So you know that it dropped very, very cold in the shipping process. And so that's why it went cloudy. It does not mess with the performance. You know, it's nothing bad. It's absolutely nothing bad. And in fact, it actually is a sign that the Tamanu oil is very pure and that it is cold pressed and not heat extracted, which is definitely what you want to look for with your facial oils. You want cold pressed oil. So the fact that it did turn cloudy is actually a sign of its superiority of it, the fact that this is a very high quality Tamanu oil. Now, if you caught my Cosrx Cica line review that I did earlier this month, you're not going to be surprised to see these next two products on the list, which is the Cica toner from Cosrx as well as their Cica pads. So let's talk about the Cica pads first, because these are, you know, I will tell you, I'm not somebody who tends to go for like toner pads. That's what this really is, like a toner pad. I don't really go for those types of products. I think they're kind of like excessive, slightly wasteful, but in the end, they're just not really for me because I'm somebody who likes to layer on lots of toner with my hands. And so I don't usually like take, you know, the toner pad and just like wipe it over my face and throw it away. That's not personally how I use these types of products. I actually use them more like a concentrated but quick sheet mask. You know, I take these cotton rounds and I place them on my cheeks, my forehead, and my chin, and I let them kind of infuse with my skin for about 3 minutes. And when you use it like that, I think that these are actually really, really effective. This is one of the fastest acting products that I've used to relieve irritation. It has a deep irritation relief that I just think is really, really special. I really want to hit that home. There is such a beautiful calming effect to this product that the first time I used it, I was like, whoa, because I did have that irritation around my mouth. And so when I put it around my chin area, I really just started to feel, you know, like those types of products that give irritation relief, they don't like make your skin feel tingly or anything, but they just have this like refreshing, cooling relief to them. That's how this feels, because these are actually really deeply hydrating on top of the irritation relief. They actually pack a hydration punch that really just, you know, dives deeply into the skin. If you have dehydration, like I think you'd also like these too. Anyways, I mean, like there's just something really special that I feel when I put this onto my skin that, like I said, the first time I used it, I was really impressed with them. So this has become a really trusty, reliable product because I have been going through a little bit more irritation and some more redness. And this is a nice way to get like that masking experience in my routine without having to really dedicate that full amount of time to like a sheet mask. So yeah, I'm a really big fan of this product. And I think that this could be a must have for those with sensitive skin. So let's talk about the toner next. This is actually a really, I think this might be a major discovery for me. You know what I mean? Because like the first time I used it, I was like, this might change everything. As you know, I have very impossibly high standards for toners. I demand a lot from my toner. Not every toning product can give me what I need. I have very thirsty, very dehydrated skin. I have very specific preferences when it comes to texture with my main toners. And you know, you also avoid a lot of ingredients too. So, you know, anyways, it's hard for me to find that one kind of like perfect, for lack of a better word, you know, I don't always like calling things holy grail, but holy grail types of products, right? There's a very certain handful of toners that have made it to my winner circle. You are all very familiar with which ones those would be. This is in the winner circle. Yeah, it's not every day you get to induct a new toner into Kelly's like winner circle, but I am inducting the Cica toner into the winner circle. I'm incredibly impressed with this. It's my preferred texture. Really, really watery, really, really light, quickly absorbed, can layer up multiple times without building up greasy on the skin. Love it. I love multiple layers with my toners. It's got deep hydration. And that's really the key when it comes to me and my personal dehydration. I want that toner that just feels like it goes the extra mile into my skin. And it not just hydrates, but it replenishes my skin. It heals my dehydration. It doesn't just put a band-aid over it, right? It really gets in there. And that's how I feel about this toner. It really dives in deep. It's got a real special feel on the skin. It also is incredibly calming. You know, I rarely say this, and I know I have not really been talking about Keep Cool that much because of the issues that have been going on with the brand, but I can tell you that this is one toner I could see being just as good as that one. Now, as I mentioned, you know, I really struggled with a lot of dryness and irritation on my skin this month. I call it winterized skin because, like, winter just hit me. It hit me with the winter stick. It abused my skin. It happens every year, you know, just the dead, and that's really where we're just getting into the coldest and the most harshest, just the deadest of winter right now. We are, and it really hit my skin this month. So not only did I have really dry and irritated skin, I actually got very chapped lips. Like, more chapped and more severe than I've had in many, many years. And the irritation and the chapped feeling actually extended beyond the borders of my lips to my lower chin and also just a little bit above my upper lip. It was really bad. And it was like all I could think about because it's, you know, pretty painful. So the lip products that I've been using for years and years to keep my lips in good shape, which are pretty prone to dryness as it is, just weren't cutting it. So I was like, uh-oh, what do I do? You know, Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask is gorgeous. I use it morning and night, but I'm not slathering that on my chin. I'm not that desperate, right? So I definitely needed to find something new. And I am really grateful to have found the Coco Kind My Matcha All Over Moisture Stick. Now, this brand actually sent me a PR package, and I was like pretty excited because, like, I don't know a lot about the brand. But this one kind of like caught my attention immediately because it is basically, you want to think about this like kind of like an oil stick or like a balmy oil kind of treatment. There's only three ingredients in here. It's coconut oil, beeswax, and green tea powder. And it's basically like a giant chapstick. So you can use this like on your lips. They say you can use it like under your eye area to give yourself a boost of moisture. Use it on dry patches, just multi-purpose. Wherever you need a little bit of moisture, this one's got you, right? And so what I actually started to do was put it on my lips. Now, this isn't really a good dedicated lip product. And why I say that is because this is, with just those three ingredients, you can kind of assume it's not long lasting. It's not really occlusive. It's not really a lip product in that sense. It's a moisture stick. So what I do is I actually put this all over my lips. It's clear, it's transparent, it's not sticky or balmy or shiny, so I can extend the moisture stick to the other areas beyond the borders of my lips, and then I'll just top it off just on my lip area with a regular lip product that's a little bit more long lasting. So really just layer this under your lip products. It gives you that extra boost of moisture that you may be craving. And I really needed like that oil. I have been putting like just direct oil onto my lips, but I can't do that all day long, right? So this is actually just like a really easy on the go kind of, exactly what it calls itself, a moisture stick. And I gotta do a shout out to the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Wild Oat Hydrating Toner. Now, I did cover this in my moisturizing toners video that I did at the beginning of January, and I just wanted to update you guys. You know, I'm still really enjoying this product so much. I have been trying a variety of different products from First Aid Beauty, and I will admit I have been mostly impressed with them. There was a few duds for sure, but generally I have a very favorable opinion of this brand. And this is one of the products that is really kind of like, really shot up to one of my favorites from them. Definitely top favorite from First Aid Beauty. Now, as I mentioned before, I have very high standards, like a very high bar for the toners that I really, really like. And this one is kind of an odd man out, if you will, because it's not at all like the Cosrx Cica toner that we talked about. It's milky, it's got a little bit of body to it, but actually it's a lot lighter on your skin than it appears when you first get it out onto like your hand, because it's got really great spread and it absorbs into the skin really beautifully. It does have hydration. It does have that watery kind of feel to it, but then there is that moisture, that balancing moisture right when it absorbs into your skin. That feels really good. Especially if you do have irritated skin, I do feel like a little bit of moisture can help. And so this is nice. And it's not a greasy moisture. Do you know what I mean? Because some moisturizing toners can feel quite thick on the skin. They can leave like a film or a shininess or a finish at the top of your skin. It can make layering other things on top of that a little bit tricky, right? This just has such a pleasing texture for being a moisturizing toner because they've really balanced it between the hydration and the moisture content of this toner, I think, really effectively. Of course, the star ingredient here is the oatmeal, beautiful for calming sensitive skin. It's got a wonderful anti-inflammation property to it. But we also have some non-greasy moisture players here like honey and propolis. And that's just really how this feels on the skin. Non-greasy, but just that right amount of moisture to really balance the skin. And I really feel like this is a toner that I can use in warm weather too, because it's not heavy, it's not super thick. It's just the right amount of balance. So anyways, I'm just really impressed with this one. You know, it is a little bit different than my preferred toners, but I'm still getting a lot of use out of this one. It layers like a dream. I don't have to like create a whole routine around this, you know what I mean, to make it work in my routine. It plays well with so many different products. And I do think it's a winner, and it's one that you don't hear about a lot from this brand. I think it might be a slightly newer product, but I do think it's really great. And finally, you know, I think we're all, maybe not all of us, but a lot of us are on a sunscreen quest now. So many of our favorite sunscreens are just no longer options, right? This is the new kind of big thing that is happening in the Korean skincare space right now with the sunscreen issue. And we're all just kind of trying to find some new products and kind of know what we want to look for in our sunscreens. And I am going to commit myself to testing some new sunscreens so that we have some other options to look at. So I will be doing that in the coming months. Definitely be patient with me, because you know I like to take my time with products, but I do want to mention a sunscreen in this month's video that I think you guys may want to consider. It's a possibility. And I have talked about this sunscreen before. It is the Ami Verdeo UV Moisture Essence. This is a chemical sunscreen that uses 4 different chemical filters. And I think a big thing that is starting to come out right now is a lot of us are looking to avoid chemical sunscreens with just 2 filters. So this has a variety of different chemical filters in it. It's got that nice pleasing kind of airy texture to it. It's no white cast. It absorbs really nicely. It's got a good dry time on it. It feels very comfortable, non-drying on the skin. I personally don't get irritation from this one, but there are some older generation filters in this. You want to keep your eye on that. If you do know that that is one of your sensitivities, it's not one of mine personally, so I don't have a problem with this one, but it feels really great. Airy, light, breathable, great texture on the skin. I will mention this, it does have a little bit of a dewy finish on the skin. It's not too bad, but for more oily skin types, I think you might feel a little bit too dewy with this one. There is a gel version of this that solves that problem, so you may want to take a look at that one. I'll put a link in the info box for you guys. But I think that this is a really nice kind of substitute for some of our favorite really light, airy, cosmetically elegant sunscreens. But I personally, and you know, you can never know for sure, right? But we're all just trying to do a little bit better these days and try to just be more educated as best as we can. I personally am starting to look for sunscreens with more than two filters in it, right, for the chemical side of things. And so this kind of fits the bill. This is something I've already reviewed in depth, something I have on hand already. And so this is something that I've been leaning on a lot over the past month. As we know, a lot of our favorite sunscreens have failed and some more are probably to come. So yeah, it's definitely a time for us to start exploring some new products. So I hope you guys enjoyed this month's favorite video. You know, this month is not at all the way that I thought the new year, how I thought 2021 would be, but you know what? We're just getting started. And honestly, I do still feel so much like optimism and hope. I just feel so good. Like I know this year there's gonna be good stuff ahead. I feel it coming. There's a light at the end of the tunnel and we are just getting closer. You know, we have been through so much already and we just do not give ourselves credit for everything we have been through, that we have gotten through, everything that we have, we have not given ourselves enough credit. Like, you are strong. Like, you are so capable. Like, you are just really amazing for everything that you've done in the last, you know, almost a year now that we've been, especially with the pandemic situation, right? Like, you are so amazing and so strong, and you just keep going in the face of it all. You just keep going. And that is something we just do not give ourselves credit for, but it is going to get better. I really feel it. I really do. And you're gonna feel it too soon. I know it. So let me know what, let's get off that subject, right? Let me know what some of your favorite products were this month. Let me know in the comment box below. If you enjoyed this video, it was helpful to you, but maybe you're not subscribed to my channel yet, but you made it this far in the video, you know, maybe you might consider subscribing to my channel before you go. I do release 2 new skincare focused videos, and turn on the notifications so you don't miss out on those videos when I post them throughout the week. I hope you guys are healthy, happy, and safe wherever you are in the world. And I can't wait to talk to you in the next video. Bye.